So hi everyone, here we are making the Lebanese pickle. So take a whole cucumber and get the center piece out. We don't need to use it. And we're going to be cutting the cucumber in long, thin stripes. Here I'm adding three vegetables, carrot, onion and cucumber. You could add beetroot, you could add green chilies. That's how we're cutting the onions. It's got to be not very thin, not very thick. Yes. That's how we are cutting our carrots. So they got to be nice and thin so that they're edible and they'll fit into the falafel well. So here I have all my three vegetables. I'm going to put them in a bowl. This is a pickle, so this should be made at least 4 hours before your main dish is served, because we're going to now marinate it and leave it to soak. It's a great idea if you can make this one day before. The more it's marinated, the more it's going to soak in the flavors. So here I'm adding some olive oil. Some vinegar, a lot of vinegar actually, some powdered sugar, or you could also do with the normal sugar, either is okay. So I'm adding 2 spoons of powdered sugar, some salt and some red chili, and you're going to mix it very, very well. And it's ready now, but this will be left to be marinated in a closed bowl, a closed container, for at least 3 hours minimum, 3 to 4 hours. But if it's done for 24 hours, it's going to be give you a great taste. So there I'm putting it. I'm going to leave it marinated for some time. Yeah, I'm going to leave this in a closed box. Shake it up well. My chickpeas. We don't have to add any water to this. So I'm going to do it in 2 times. I'm going to add the coriander. Half of the garlic. Half of the onion. And half of the green chilies. Hello my dear friends, time to make some good yummy Lebanese food. We're going to make it a very elaborate menu today. So here I'm kneading the dough for the pita bread, and I'm going to do the prep and share the recipe of the pickle. And I would highly suggest the pickle should be made at least 24 hours before, if not 24 hours, at least 5 hours before you serve it, and leave it for marination for 3 to 5 hours. So here we're getting started with the main pita dough. That's our regular wheat. So I'm going to just take a little bit. That's maida, the whole flour, double the quantity. I'm going to be adding some sugar in it, some olive oil, and here I'm using some dry yeast. Just going to be adding that a little bit. I'm going to be adding some warm water, and I will let this rest and allow the yeast to come up. So I'm going to let this rest for say about a couple of minutes. Let the yeast mixture rest for some time. In another bowl, I've taken all-purpose flour, that's maida. So I've taken 4 full spatulas of this. I've added 1 spoon of salt and 1 spoon of sugar, and now we're going to be mixing this previously kneaded yeast mix into this to make a nice dough. And we're going to knead it with our hands. So there's my dough, nice sticky, and you got to knead it at least for 10 minutes, and just make sure you do it with your hands. And once it's done in 10 minutes, I'll leave it to rest with the covered with a wet cloth for an hour while I make my other preparation. And the thumb rule is it's got to be very sticky and loose, the water content. So if it's loose, please don't add in more flour, because this is going to help us make very nice puffy pita bread. So it's got to be like this consistency. So if you see, sticky consistency. Once we've kneaded the dough and we've set it aside and we've made the salad, now this is where we are making the falafel. These are chickpeas soaked overnight. That's basic coriander leaves, hara dhania. That's a garlic, 1½ onion, chopped very coarse, not finely. That's coriander powder. That's black cumin powder, kala jeera, salt, green chilies, pepper, and some garam masala. Now we're going to be adding all of this in a blender at once to coarsely grind it into a mix. My chickpeas. We don't have to add any water to this. So I'm going to do it in two times. I'm going to add the coriander. Half of the garlic. Half of the onion. And half of the green chilies. That's how my falafel mixture looks. And now I'm going to add in some gram flour basin. So about 4 teaspoons of basin, 3 or 4, and that will keep the whole mixture in place. And we're going to just keep this mixture aside while we prepare the other ingredients. That's our falafel mix, and I've wrapped it up with the plastic. I'm going to leave it in the fridge for about half an hour to settle and soak in the flavors. Once we've kneaded the dough and we've set it aside and we've made the salad, now this is where we are making the falafel. These are chickpeas soaked overnight. That's basic coriander leaves, hara dhania. That's a garlic, 1½ onion, chopped very coarse, not finely. That's coriander powder. That's black cumin powder, kala jeera, salt, green chilies, pepper, and some garam masala. Now we're going to be adding all of this in a blender at once to coarsely grind it into a mix. My chickpeas. We don't have to add any water to this. So I'm going to do it in two times. I'm going to add the coriander. Half of the garlic. We don't have to add any water to this. So I'm going to do it in two times. I'm going to add the coriander. Half of the garlic. So our next step here is to make some tabbouleh. Tabbouleh again is a Lebanese salad. And I just want you all to know that Lebanese food and South Indian food is very, very close to my heart, because I was born and brought up in Bangalore for a part of my life. And I grew up in Dubai. So these recipes just come to me very naturally. And they've been a part of my childhood experience and my youth. Tabbouleh is basically, what we need is some couscous, which I've soaked and strained. Now, if you don't have couscous, it's okay. You can make it without couscous. Here, I have 3 herbs put together. That's mint, fresh mint, coriander, and celery. But the original recipe is mint, coriander, and parsley. But since I don't have parsley now, so I've added these 3 herbs, fresh herbs chopped finely. Here is tomatoes and onions and some more of coriander. That's some walnuts, black pepper, salt, and some lemon. All of these ingredients together. So I'm going to be using about 6 to 7 spoons of couscous. We'll add in some herbs. Now the main thing about tabbouleh is it's got to be very lemony. So the prominent flavors in this is going to be lemon and black pepper. There's my tabbouleh ready. I've mixed in all the ingredients and then I've topped it with some chopped walnuts. You could also top it with some almonds, peanuts, whatever nut you have available. And the prominent taste in tabbouleh is lemony and peppery, black peppery. Yeah, and there goes my tabbouleh. And now we're going to go to the next dip, which is called mutabbal. Putting the hummus together. The secret behind good smooth hummus is where you have the boiled chickpeas. While boiling them, I've added some baking soda and some salt. Now it's very important to get these with soda. What happens is the peels of the chickpeas come out, so please strain them. You could add some cold water, it'll help you strain all the peels from the top. Very essential to have very smooth hummus, creamy soft hummus. That's the secret. We don't need these upper peels off, so just mix it well and strain off all the. So here are the chickpeas that are removed. I've removed the peel and I'm going to add into a blender tahini paste that we made, most of it.